So this is the thing. Now this is one way of finding the or working out the present value of the salary. The other way is to find out the real rate of interest and discount the real cash flows with the real rate of interest. Now what you are doing here? What presently you are doing? You are first going to future and then coming to present. Can we apply single way? Yes, we can. How it can be possible to apply a single way to arrive the similar things? See, that what is called real and the nominal rate of interest. Okay. So what is the real rate of interest? The interest and the consumption. The real rate. Now what is the real rate of interest? Interest, what is interest rate first of all? Interest rate measures the opportunity cost of immediate consumption. Interest rate fluctuates over time. In order to understand this fluctuation, consider what influences the immediate consumption. What is the interest rate? I told you on that day. What is interest? Interest is in something which you are interested in. Okay, and you don't want to forgo it. It means that everyone likes immediate consumption. Okay, and if further, one of the most important determinant of interest rate is the expected inflation. Because if it is expected that price will rise, there will be fall in the interest rates. Suppose the consumer price index is expected to jump because of the price of the goods and services are expected to increase. Price of the goods and services are expected to increase. What the consumer will do? Consumers are not likely to accelerate the consumption plans to avoid the likely price rise. What the people will do? They will start accumulating the things. Just see what happens when there is news in the market that the price of petrol is going to increase. People used to get their petrol tanks filled. It means the consumption increases. The consumption tendency of any individual increases with increase in the price. With expected increase in the price or expected inflation. Okay? How would you expect interest rates to respond to this event? Anyone? What will be the effect on interest rate on expected inflation? Tell me. Interest rate will?
Increase.
Who says increase and who says decrease and why? Raise your hands, who says the interest rate will increase? Raise your hands like this. And who says interest rate will decrease? Those who are having nothing to say, they may go out of the class. So think it off once again. You have to raise your hand. Either the interest rate will increase or the interest rate will decrease. Will increase in inflation or expectation of increase in inflation, what will be the effect on the interest rates? Decrease or increase?
Decrease.
Who says decrease? Raise your hands. Raise your hands like this so that I can see. What about those who say the opposite? Raise your hands. Raise your hands like this. Okay, fine. So equal. So can you tell me, can anyone of you tell me the reason of increase or decrease? Yes?
Sir, as the inflation increases, the value of money decreases, which means that more of money is charging less of commodity. So if the inflation increases, more of interest will be charged in order because the value of money is decreasing.
Not a free market is to be considered.
Sir, according to me, it will decrease because in case if inflation is there, so purchasing power for consumer will decrease. So in order to overcome it, rate of interest rate will decrease.
If inflation expectation increases, there is a shift in from savings to consumption. Now tell me that. It will increase or decrease. There is a shift from savings to consumption. I mean, whatever you have saved, you will start consuming that. Because you want to overcome that. If the inflation will increase, the interest rate will decrease. Why? Because it will result in selling off of investments which you have made for your savings. Okay, and as you will keep on selling or redemption of the interest bearing securities, with the rise in price, the interest rate falls down. Okay, conversely, if price falls, the interest rate will rise. Therefore, interest rate increases with expectation of inflation. Expectation. I am not talking of actual inflation, mind you. It is the expectation of inflation. To isolate the effect of inflation, expectation of interest rate, economist Irwin Fisher has made distinction between real and nominal interest rates and corresponding to real cash flow and the nominal cash flow. And what is the Fisher equation? Real cash flow is equal to between real cash flow and nominal cash flow. The difference into the real and front of you only in this formula itself, that real cash flows are inflation. Nominal cash flows adjusted with the
inflation
rate. Real cash flows are inflation adjusted nominal cash flows, you can say. Are you getting the point? Everyone? What is given over here? Real cash flows are equal to nominal cash flows but adjusted with the inflation. Okay. So the Fisher equation continued in another form. 1 plus R real is equal to 1 plus R nominal upon 1 plus inflation rate. Okay? And or you can say, you can turn it like that, nominal is equal to real multiplied by 1 plus. Nominal will be equal to 1 plus real multiplied by 1 plus inflation. So if you need to calculate the nominal cash flow, you have to multiply the
inflation
rate by this real rate by inflation rate. Okay? Shall I proceed? Yes. Now in the above example, what is what just now we have done? Where the person's annual salary of rupees 1 lakh was to grow 10% annually for 5 years and the discounting rate was 12%, what will be the real rate of interest? The real rate of interest will be 1.018. 12 upon, that is the nominal. Nominal interest rate is the interest at the whatsoever is going in the economy divided by the inflation rate. To what extent the salary was getting inflated?
10%.
To what rate? 10%. So the effective rate is 1.8. Now you do one thing. Again, come on upon your Excel. So the same amount, the same things can be calculated and you will see there will be no difference in it. Now calculate it with the real inflation rate. That is, you can do it by just only one discounting is required. Previously you did first compounding and then discounting. Now what you will do? You will calculate the nominal rate. That is, real cash flow need to be calculated first before applying the real rate of interest and discounting factor as this is the factor which you need to calculate. That is to be done. And then further you have to discount it by using 1.2. Now what the thing is? Salary is 1 lakh rupees. Now no need to go for compounding. What is the salary? Salary 1 lakh rupees for the all the years, because we are just adjusting the rate. And what will be the present value of that salary now? That is the real cash flow which you will be getting. So first it has to be adjusted as per the real cash flow factor. Okay, so 1 lakh needs the adjustment, that is nominal cash flow. What is the nominal cash flow? So B6 will be the nominal cash flow.
1 lakh.
Plus 1 plus inflation rate. What is the inflation rate?
Interest.
Okay, by this you will be getting the
real cash flow.
Real cash flow. And here this is to be freezed. That's why dollar C, dollar D. And then you will get the, what you will be getting? Real cash flow. Now this real cash flow will be discounted with the help of, what is the rate we have used for discounting?
1.8%.
Okay. Of course 1.8, because 12% divided by 10%. The nominal rate of interest divided by inflation rate, you will get the real. Now real cash flows will be discounted by the real rate of return. Okay? 1.8 present value factor at 1.8 you will be calculating. Okay, do it now everyone. Do it now. Inflation rate. Just inflation rate you have to take. It means you have to discount it using the inflation rate only. That is the real cash flow you will be having. Okay, what is the present value of the real cash flow you will be having is the inflation rate. 1 lakh is the salary. So what will functions of Excel. Okay, thank you, see you tomorrow.